Ladies and Germans, how are you all doing? This is Count Ulrich.
I'm Rangru. Hello, hello, hello.
And we're not bringing you any Steel Division PDX today. No, today, guys, we're bringing you back to ranked matches. Now, Rang, you said something really important happened with the Santa Claus patch. What was that?
Well, if you didn't know, pretty much every single 1v1 ranked match is now close combat. Some people like it, some people don't. It's really kind of a toss-up between both sides. But yeah, so everything's gonna be quite a bit close, and we haven't really seen that much close combat, especially with the Paradox tournament. It's all been like
A little more
regular
relaxed.
conquest. Now, I do like the 50, you have to have 52% to get the plus run in close combat. Makes it a lot
True.
more, a little less back and forth.
That's
And
very, very
yeah.
true. So I guess we're gonna be popping out a little bit of a casting cherry on the CQB today, though. And actually, for our kind of inaugural match of this kind of approach, what's it's Hill 112, isn't it?
Yep.
And who do we have fighting?
Well, on the left-hand side, blue, we have Gondi as the Polar Armor Division. And on the right-hand side, we have Saint Blindfire as the 16 Luftwaffe Division. And funnily enough, we've seen this matchup before on this exact same map. It was like
True.
a few weeks ago, I think.
True. But I guess my question for you is, looking at the way that these guys are set up, since they're so close now, actually, we're gonna get started right immediately, so
Yeah.
forget maybe what I was gonna be looking at. Take us through the matchup. How about that?
Okay, so A phase, Poles just want to get Cromwells with 95 mm cannons. Gondi wants to get 88 mm. Yeah, it's really going to be a battle between howitzers and big scary German guns, especially on this more open area of map. You do have Saint Blindfire rushing for the hill with his infantry forces and a good pack gun set down to try and negate any tank play.
Now, I do have to say, I do think that 16 Luftwaffe gets itself a little bit more power with not having to set up so far away from everybody
Oh
else.
yeah, especially all units are very slow. I'm actually surprised I didn't see any single French tanks because in close combat, the French tanks are a really good deployment unit as they're right at the front line. It's definitely worthwhile to bring a card of them.
That is true. Now, are you surprised by the fact that we have so much Polish infantry in the north? Meanwhile, it seems the Germans don't have too much of a presence really anywhere on the field.
Yeah, I think the Germans have really just they spent a lot of money on those two Flak 88s and on this southern pretty much hill attack, try to get the top of the hill, which is probably the best move to do because it's much easier to fight down a hill than fighting uphill. The pioneers are getting rickety wrecked and the Stuart is running around absolutely destroying face, so I don't think it's gonna go too well for Saint Blindfire.
That's probably a good call. I mean, if you're looking at it right now, I'm happy you made that comment. I was a little surprised when I actually don't see. Oh no, I never mind. That pack gun was there super early and got taken out super, super fast. Now, Polish infantry against the Luftwaffe early infantry. Shockingly enough, we are seeing the Poles are giving ground quite a bit.
Oh yeah.
And I don't know. For me, that seems like that's a very, very odd matchup, even with the pioneers in the area. Am I wrong on that?
I think the pioneers. Let me just double check. Oh yeah, no, there wasn't no satchel charges on the Polish dudes, but I think that the Stuart helps out quite a lot in the firepower department. He didn't get any of the regular grenadiers, which have the crappy Panzer Faustpatron, and if he had one of those, that Stuart would have easily gone down. But yeah, in terms of infantry matchup, it's pretty fair. I mean, Luftwaffe pioneers really do beat out the Poles, but the Poles can just spam out riflemen like absolute crazy, or Strzelczyki to be more exact. And matched up with tanks, they work really well, and the Poles have a lot of tanks.
I guess the thing that surprises me, though, at the same time, if you're looking at I mean, the disheartened. Maybe I always put too much stock in this, but I feel like the disheartened really, really hammers a 16th Luftwaffe.
Yeah, it hurts him quite a bit. That 25% suppression bonus, even though it's not, you take 25% more damage, but if your guys stop shooting, they're kind of worthless, you know? So, especially in CQC fights where suppression goes up really fast, because if you get suppressed too fast, especially with Luftwaffe Pioneers, you ain't gonna get your grenade off, and you kind of want that grenade off. You want to make
Very,
that
very
big bada
true.
boom.
Well, it does look at the sheriff of Pullingham's troops are going to come in to pinch out those German freedom fighters. And I don't know. I mean, we are going to finally see the 52% come over here for Gandhi. And wow,
It's
I
really
am
just
surprised.
come down to Gondi getting those Cromwells because they can dominate pretty much Luftwaffe throughout all the phases, because they can deal with the 88mm because they have the same range,
mm-hmm.
and of all the infantry and all the soft targets, and especially on a map like this, where it's very open range. Last time we saw this matchup on this map, it was Cromwell's proved to be a real pain in the butt, essentially, for the Luftwaffe player until they managed to destroy them all.
That's definitely true. Definitely left the Germans kind of out in the cold.
Mm-hmm.
And speaking of the cold, how are you staying warm up there, Rang, in the frigid north?
Well, right now I am holed up in an igloo. I meant to get a small fire going in the ground, so I'm probably going to go and hunt some more geese to feed my mooses.
Sounds about right. Just yep. Be sure, whenever you walk out and you see bear tracks, remember, bears walk in single file to hide their numbers.
Yep. Same with Tuscan Raiders.
Exactly. You know what? George Lucas was right about one thing. Gotta watch out.
Yeah.
We are going to see finally some initial... Oh, never mind. I mean, 109 says, oh, look, there's troops. Never mind, I want to go home. Forget it. And Lend-Lease is actually in full force here. We are going to see a Flak Panzer Bren E coming on out. But I'm pretty sure that the English didn't really intend to give that over to the Germans.
I think that wasn't on purpose yet, Lend-Lease. I think it's more like a lend-a-take and no givesy-backsies.
Ah, you're right. No Indian giving? Is that the...
No, it's more... I'd say it's more of a pirate job.
Aha. Got you. Yep. But in the meantime, Germans have nobody left in the southern, what do you say, 25%, third of the map? That's horrible.
It's not good at all, and the Poles really do have quite a lot of map presence. They got tanks all over, infantry all over, where Luftwaffe is really holed up in a few areas with... Not really much. I mean, they've got one Flak 88, which is pretty awesome, but it's only so much you can do with Flak 88.
Yeah, shockingly enough, this isn't the desert after all. Yeah, they really, really need to have that open line of sight, don't they?
Yeah, and even then, you know, Poles get Sexton out or the Sexton battery. They're buggered because every single time you see Luftwaffe, biggest weakness is artillery.
Exactly true. Is there anything that can be done from the Luftwaffe side to counter this, though? Realistically speaking.
I know, that's the tough thing, because Sextons are really hard to counter, because they're an armored SPG. You can't really counter battery them out effectively, because they take suppression like an absolute champ. Really, it's about... it's trying to be, like, aggressive and mobile. You know, it's really hard to do when all your units are extremely slow. And, hopefully just getting that air power out in B phase so they can at least stun up every single Polish advance with a good old, you know, Focke-Wulf or JU-188 in this case, strafing run.
Now, we are going to see some of those Jaegers coming on out, the Jaegers and the Fusiliers kind of in the same area. But I don't know, seeing this triple stack out and coming on out, while I could understand your comment earlier on about the Cromwells really laying siege, would not maybe... putting the stag hounds earlier been more effective than putting the points into the Cromwells?
I'd honestly say the Cromwells would be the better choice, as they're extremely useful, as you can see right now, in knocking out the 88s. So if they can knock out the S88, the stag hounds will have absolute free reign, apart from out, you know, one pack 50mm in the middle to just have fun. And once you knock out 88s, you can bring out the rest of the tanks and they do all the damage.
Very, very accurate. I guess I was just trying to play counterpunchers for a second, just to see what's going on with that.
It's really tough to play Luftwaffe. I always will hold you at sentiment, especially in a 1v1, because they're much more better in a supporting role than a direct combat role. You can make it work, and we have seen it happen. It's just it's extremely tough playing a 1v1 when you don't have any like aggressive units that can exploit like a weakness or a hole in the enemy lines. I mean, you can't exactly do a fast charge with FT-17s.
That is true. I guess at the same time, I have to turn around and kind of ask the question. Looking at, I'm not going to say really the German infantry, but maybe could you have thought that he could have placed his AT guns better, as we do see that second 88 is going to go down?
Maybe. At the same time, you can need to have them in the middle of the field, because you can't exactly hide a Flak 88. And then, like I said, once you get the Cromwell out and you got a little bit of suppression on that 88, it's pretty much good as dead. He does manage to knock out one stack under of a good old Panda Strike up north, so...
Indeed, yep.
Good bloody shot, yeah.
Good bloody shot. And wait, are we actually seeing some Ooh, what's coming on in? Nah, it's the 730s are coming in. Okay.
The FT-17s. It's going to be fun to see him actually do something in 5 minutes.
For some reason, all I can think right now is just the Great Escape theme is going through my head. I don't know why.
It's going to be a very slow Great Escape.
Well, it took him a while to build that tunnel, so... but more Cromwell's and more infantry looking to exploit that northern position.
Mm-hmm.
And indeed, that Cromwell's going to a supporting job. It looks like that Pantertrek squad is just going to take intense amount of firepower.
Yeah, and this is not good for the German player at all. His whole middle flank is suppressed and now being forced to fall back up north. He's losing ground everywhere. He's losing ground and momentum, and it's about to hit B phase, so... Maybe he can pull something else from B phase, get a lot of planes, a lot of firepower, but...
I think the one saving grace about this is that Flakpanzer coming on in might be just barely enough to stave off the initial kind of Polish attack.
I mean, it can stop the infantry, but, I mean, the Cromwell and the Stuart, not so much, bud. Not so much.
Not so much. That seems a rather, Wow, I'm not even... Okay, fair enough. Never mind. You know, it's been a long week for me. Honestly, I would tell my tale of lamentation, but you have to tune in next time for that, folks. I'm not going to waste a conversation on this one. We are going to see Hurricane coming on in. 20 mil cannons are going to strafe down, and yeah, now you're right. Germans are falling back in disarray pretty much across the board.
Yeah, we've got two Messerschmitts now chasing in that Hurricane. Should be able to intercept and kill it, because the Hurricane is slow as hell. Yeah, never mind. They're both...
Okay, drop Mustang. Your bombs. Screw it. Who cares the Mustang's there? Drop your bombs. Make the ordnance worthwhile. I realize that they wouldn't make it out alive. I'm just noting.
You just want to see some booms.
I do. I like finally seeing the 250, SC bombs coming on out.
Yeah.
And frankly, if you give a kind of southern enough approach, you can have that Flakpanzer to cover your planes a little bit more.
But, I don't know how the Germans are going to come back from this, Khan. It's not looking good at all. The Poles have so much more presence. And once the Poles get that tank ball rolling and getting all the armored vehicles, as you can see, it's really hard to just try and destroy them all, especially when they're attacking on all flanks. And that's really what we're seeing. We've got Cromwell, Staghounds, and Sturz all over the map, covering everything. And the Germans, they have no anti-tank. Except for infantry.
That's true.
No pack guns, no flat guns, no Stug Freeze, no HSB Freeze.
Let's give a little bit of credit, though. This is where the Luftwaffe is going to get a little bit of a shot in the arm. I mean, their supply at this point does raise up by 50% or so. Yep. So.
But it's really going to come down to trying to get something done now. You know, getting a B1 to knock out four tanks in one strafing run. Or just getting some tank, a Stug Free to try and counter some of the Polish armor.
Is he stepping into an attack run? No, he's not. Okay. I keep hoping he's going to send one of these ME-109s. Okay, there's a very, very quick attack run. Hurricane's too far away to really do any sort of support. Okay, I feel like that's what he has to do.
Yeah.
Constantly have air power over top of the front lines.
Yeah. You know, get those cheap Messerschmitts and Focke-Wulfs. They work really well. For Luftwaffe deck, as you can actually afford them instead of, you know, saving up 3 minutes for JU-1 88, and they're pretty good. They can come in constantly. Here we go. This is what we need. We need a B1, Khan. Can the B1?
That's true. That's true. But he has a very, very small window. We have a Crusader coming in from the western side of the map. Tracks.
Here we go. Okay. He needs to knock out half of the tanks, and he's gonna be good. He's got air power, which is exactly how he should be bringing out.
But he's got to get it before that B1 goes down. He's got to suppress.
Oh, yeah, he's going to get it.
Okay, thank God.
The Hurricane is...
going to get rocked, and there it goes.
And that's why you get fighter support with your B1s or HS-129s. Because if it didn't have it yet, he would have been toast, and there goes 200 points. And is that... Are we seeing... Okay, another Flak ATA. I was really hoping for Flak C Violin, but... ATH, they're the better choice.
Now, I was approached the other day. I was asked by... a viewer, whether or not I really kind of endorse rushing an early Junkers in any sort of setup against a more mechanized ally deck. Now, I know what I would say to that. I'm willing to get your perspective on it.
Are we talking about Junkers anti-tank or Junkers bomber?
Talking about a Junkers anti-tank.
Junkers anti-tank, at the start of a match?
Yes, right at the start? Phase A, do you go and save for it?
Oh, that's some raw game, like napalm bombing off the start stuff, right? Yeah. Well, the problem with doing that is that you really have bad line of sight and accuracy, or like knowing where the enemy is. It's honestly probably a pretty safe bet because most people don't buy planes or anti-air at the start, but at the same time, that's a lot of money wasted. If you don't get a kill on any tanks, if you can't see any, and also if you get shot down, it's one of those things where if it works, it's great, and it's definitely worthwhile if you can knock out like a Ram 2 or Sherman off the start. But and it's also it just ticks off the enemy, and that's always a good thing to try and accomplish. But if it doesn't work out, you really screwed yourself up in the deep end as you knock yourself out by like 160, 180 points. I think it's like 160. I
I don't know.
forgot the price.
I have to admit, and we got to get back to gaming thing in
Yep.
just a second. We are at a plus two, 865 to nothing right now. Gandhi is definitely leading the charge on this. He's losing a couple of infantry units here and there. I don't know. I actually kind of expected you were going to have a much more hardline opinion with that. For me, I thought it was a much less positive investment early on.
Yeah, it's just very. It's very risky, especially. I mean, you're only gonna want to use it against decks that can really bring out Shermans or any scary tanks in A phase. But I don't know. It's just. I mean, doing it at the start, you do can catch them off surprise, as like I said, don't really get plane draw AA off the bat in most decks, so you're safe in that regard. It's just being able to pay off immediately.
Exactly. And I don't know. I didn't see enough utility in getting rushing out an early plane that you might not ever really get to use. And like you said, we might even go and lose it super fast. And where are you? Well, you're up a creek without a paddle.
Yeah, I will always highly recommend spamming like regular Junker bombers, like the cheap 110 point runs. They're so good once you get like two or three of them because they have so much veterancy that they can just fly in, survive a bunch of AA fire, and then get out. I mean, they can't kill much, but they can stun up, a good force multiple times. For 110 points, it's a bargain bucket deal.
All right, I have to say, I do love. Even with the Crusaders out, I do love this. Let's throw all this air power up. You have now the idiots to suppress and support. This could be the heyday for the Luftwaffe.
Yeah, I mean, they got the Messerschmitt, they got the Focke-Wulf. Even though EA has no proper fighters, the rocket and bomber Messerschmitt are still pretty decent in the fighting capacity, especially once you can get those 2-star ATH on. I mean, fighting against opposing air power is actually a pretty tricky opponent, as those Hurricanes are actually good once you get into a turn fight, and especially those 2-star Mustangs. They're pretty
True.
much a slightly worse P-51. They have less armament, but they're still a damn fast 2-star P-50 run.
But we
And,
are going to see, by the way, a Sherman 5 coming out of this main load. I'm sorry to cut you off.
no problem.
We are going to see, though, it may not be the best option. He's going to be very much in that 88's line of fire.
Yeah, I mean, I'll have to take a look at the 88. It does have sight down that road, and it does have the range as well, and this is really 88 territory. If he can knock out those Cromwell Mark 6s, if I can actually know Roman
Yep, Cromwell
numerals.
six.
I mean, he can get four of them in total, and yeah, there's three on the battlefield. Haven't seen any go down. If he can knock him out, his 88s are a bit more safer. And so is his
That well,
infantry.
he's 25% of the way there.
Yeah. Okay, there we go. One down, three to go.
I
But
do look. I is he looking for the anti-air? Maybe.
maybe. I mean,
I mean, he's not going to find it pretty easily, but I'm just.
I see what you mean. But yeah, at the same time, yeah, I'm really surprised Opposed haven't got a single artillery piece, because this is a deck you spam arty against, especially Sextons. Especially Sextons.
I am surprised to see that Flak Panzer is not yet dead.
Yeah.
All it has is a little bit MG ammo, and we're going to see an actual AT gun coming on in now. But I don't know. We are going to see the B. Oh no, B1's coming in again. That there's still that Crusader. Retreat, retreat, you
No,
fool!
he's gonna kill the Cromwell, is he? Come on.
Nope.
Ah, come on, bud. Didn't even get like any major critical hit. That is a bit of a shame. Yo, he does have a stew now, which is
Yes.
I mean, it's a good unit. It's really like one of the few tanks you can actually get as Luftwaffe.
Yeah, true. I guess if he cleans up that little knot of Polish troops, that could be a good 2 or 3% of the map right there, right?
Exactly, and he can start regaining some of that ground up north. Funny little thing about the Stu, I just realized it. Even though it's like, it's like an infantry or shotgun tank, you can only get in airborne style decks.
There's a historical reason for that. Unfortunately, I cannot for the life of me recall what that was.
Same. There's probably like a good reason for it, but I know, I always think it'd be more relegated towards infantry decks, so I guess at the same time, 7/16 is just kind of French meme tanks, and 3/52, who knows.
Definitely seems like a possibility. We are 40 seconds away from phase C. It is still a +2 over here for Gandhi, but he's starting to drop some percentage points here. Because in the south, the Germans threatened to take back that highest layer of the hill cake.
And really, he has managed to keep most of his airplanes, or all of his airplanes, alive, which is really the important thing, because if he can build up air power and keep doing those bombing runs, as you can see, he's going to be having a damn good time. And
Indeed.
that's a good thing about Luftwaffe, is once you get that AA net up of 88 mm, it's pretty easy to keep all your planes alive. You don't need fighters at that point when you've got so many flak 88s that you can block out the sun, or shoot out the sun if you'll get enough of him.
Very, very true. Though it does look like Gandhi is looking to start contesting that. He's got consistently either two Mustangs or at least a Hurricane and a Mustang pretty much out all the time.
Yeah, it's pretty much just to try and negate any incursions into his territory. It's exactly what he's doing. And I'm just noticing, we got the 88s on point, we got much more infantry, the Germans are, or Saint in this case, is starting to, reinvigorate his lines and making some good progress now.
I'm surprised about that. Now we are
Yeah,
going to
I'm
see that
really surprised.
flatbed 37 mil has come on out. And Staghound's starting to die as well. And I feel like if the Germans can just muster a little bit of an attack, they're going to get surrender after surrender. That's one in the north.
That one
Of course, the
pioneer.
officer's not going to surrender, but he's a fool.
There we got Lotcher, the lone pioneer, going in for the triple surrender.
He's a fearless one. If he survives this, he deserves a medal, but I don't see that
Oh
happening.
no, no. Runs round the corner, gets shot.
That's a casting curse right there. Poles bringing in some 6-pounders to the north. Okay, there we go. That's a Crusader down. That's going to open up a lot in the northern
Oh
side to
damn.
that B1. And I'm stunned. The Germans are slowly just hammering back bit by bit. B3 to the south.
Yeah, there we go. B3, B1 combo now.
And the ME-109 is just going on in to unmask that ground fire.
Goes in for the Cromwell. Perfect target. Gets the kill. Just, one
Yeah, okay.
kill. Get out. Especially when there's enemy airplane. Oh no! The fighters aren't nearby. The
But the flak.
88 mm. The
Come
flak?
on!
Come on,
Come
Flakie.
on!
Come
Oh
on!
my god, don't move! Oh, B3 dies and.
Oh, that was. He should not have evac'd his fighters. That
Oh, I
was.
think one of those was a fuel retreat, but I might be wrong.
I was. That's. I mean, he gets revenge at least, but I mean, losing that B3 is a rather big loss because you kind of need that to blow up enemy tanks.
Indeed. Indeed. Now, looking at phase C now, so of course we do have with the Poles, we are going to see things like this Firefly coming on and the Upgun Firefly at that. 16 Luftwaffe, tanks, anti-aircraft guns, what do they have?
Nothing really much. I can get some bigger planes maybe, but
Exactly.
I know, it's really just 88 mm and crappy infantry. That's really all Luftwaffe's gonna be getting. 88 mils, disheartened infantry. Maybe a Stug 3, maybe. But it's a really simple 1-2 combo, essentially. And I think it's gonna
And
maybe get another Cromwell. Ah,
I
so
don't.
close.
I am shocked. The Poles aren't running out of infantry. We can see that as more and more just start spilling onto the battle space. But it is now 55-45. Saint Blindfire doesn't seem to think that his troops are, well, that they're going to die anytime soon. Another Flak 88 takes another Cromwell. And shockingly, the armored
There we
fighting
go.
vehicle tally is getting slimmer and slimmer.
Yeah, and this is good for the Germans, definitely, because knocking out the Cromwells, like I said, real big pain in the butts. Really, Gondi should be thinking about getting maybe. Okay, he is getting a section. Thank you.
It's only
Thank
taken
you.
25 minutes, but
Yeah, it only took
yeah.
him, yeah, 25 minutes, but, you know, better late than never. And, I mean, that's gonna be a great counter against those 88 millimeters. But Saint Blindfire, he does have momentum, he is pushing, he does have air power. The one problem here is, does he have enough time? There's only 15 minutes left in the match, and Lustrov can't exactly attack at a rapid pace. So, he needs to get like a plus three, really, if he wants a good chance of winning. And that's gonna be pretty hard, Khan. That's gonna be pretty hard, especially with only a 100-point economy.
That's true, but it doesn't look like he's too offended by that. If anything, his pain train's coming down south, and geez, infantry is still continuing to drop.
And there we go. They got the Polish plane train trying to intercept. Will he get the B1, yo? Oh, I think
My
he
gosh, I wasn't
is.
even looking at that. Yep, there it goes.
Oh,
Wow.
same place too. That is. That's a shame because the B1 keeps retreating into no man's land instead of in like the middle area here, where there's no air cover, because he always does a strafe and runs down south.
That's
That
true, but
is.
ground fire will take out a hurricane, and a
Yep.
Mustang has to retreat
Oh,
away
and
from. And
another
they take
one.
out. Oh my gosh,
Rails of the
that's actually
Messerschmitt.
pretty huge right there. That was what, like one third to like a quarter of, I think, Gandhi's actual air force, even
Yeah.
overall.
I mean, knocking out all those planes is really good, those Mustangs. So really the damage has been done. Losing both B or HS 129s hurts him a lot, as I don't believe you can really get any more apart from those two. And you kinda need those to be knocking out those very important Polish tanks. They're really your best bet at destroying the Polish tanks.
But a moment of relative calm does fall across the field. This sexton is not unleashing anything. In fact, you just see a Lend-Lease Vickers exchanging firepower with Jaegers.
Yep. Here at Firefly, we'll be able to knock out Stu and
You can see him
pretty easily
already.
get.
There
If
we
you
go.
can see him, there we go. Just
And he
barely.
gets out just barely in
Just
time.
barely.
This is like the greatest wet noodle contest of the world. Oh my gosh, I can't even watch that. Taking a look back up to the north with you, several pyres are on the field, but there's this line of defense, and that's a beautifully constructed line.
I know, it's that's a nice line. I mean, they're all lined up, ready to start shooting. We got the AT, we got the machine gun, we got the infantry and the command unit with supply backing it up. It's not a lot of firepower, really, but it's a nicely constructed line.
It's a nice little breakwater. I feel like
Yeah.
honestly, if you had any sort of indirect firepower beyond it, mortar or anything,
Yeah.
it'd be absolutely st not stunning. But
It's
off
it's
map
a nice
storage,
line.
off map storage.
Oh.
He's gonna
Oh.
get blown out of existence, but
Yep,
off map
because look,
storage.
he's retreating down south once again. Yo, oh no, he's gonna be able to get out. There we go.
I mean, there's another one coming on in. So this other hurricane, unless this hurricane gets complete. Oh, never mind. He's gone for the 109.
Yep. And 88 is gonna be able to keep him alive. But yeah, off map, I forgot they can get the off map storage, which is a pretty awesome little unit. It is an actual worthwhile recon plane.
Oh my gosh, will this hurricane go down? Hurricane goes down.
Oh
There is
damn.
not much left anymore for the Poles in terms of an air force.
That's true, but there's only 12 minutes left, and we are actually getting ground for Gondi. He is at the plus 1 point advantage, and he's
I
breaking
have
through
to
in the
stop
mid.
you real quick. I'm sorry. Isn't Saint Blindfire the Luftwaffe? Or am
Oh,
I looking
mine
at the wrong
bad.
replay
My
here?
bad. My
Okay.
bad. Yep,
Like,
I,
Gandhi,
Yep.
definitely not the non-violent sort, but yeah.
But yeah, Saint Blindfire is making good progress through the middle. He's got the plus 1 point advantage. He's very close to the plus two, actually, and there's really nothing in this center flank for the Poles to defend themselves with in terms of like proper tanks. I mean,
True.
you've got a Crusader and the Cromwell, which is going to be able to stun up the 88, but what it takes is a good rocket run or bombing run to stun him up for now.
Very true. I do kind of wish we would see either the Polish Strzelecki or the officer maybe even try to charge forward even slightly. No, never
Up
mind.
north?
Yeah, I was thinking that to try to get a surrender or two. There was some pinned down.
Yeah.
But now that 88's up, that's not going to happen.
Yeah, he didn't really have much firepower with his rods. I mean, it was a nice line. This Vickers gun is kind of run raw too late.
True.
Yeah.
True. But you're right, 55-45. Only thing really retarding German progress in the south is that Firefly.
Yeah, and I mean, he's going to be able to hold the hill easily.
As... There's going to be a breakout in the north.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, that's a huge breakout.
That's a huge breakout.
One squad for a surrender. Oh, my. Plus two. And the Germans take on infantry in the center. There is one squad of infantry other than this Streltsy that's pinned.
Yep.
Keeping the Germans from taking, like, a plus three. That, oh, my gosh.
It's, I know, but the Germans need a... They need that plus three. I think if he gets a plus three, it's only going to really be a draw. Because, look, Gondi... He just... And he has such a huge point advantage compared to St. Blindfire. That's gonna be a tough to catch up to in only, like, 10 minutes.
That's true, but the Sexton goes down. Flak 88 is going to take that out. That's another huge loss. Poles don't... So, I'm really surprised, because I felt like they weren't running out of infantry, but then I see absolutely no other infantry being brought on in.
I'm surprised, too, because as the Poles, especially when everyone now is doing the Strojki spam, you don't usually run out of infantry. But I think he's been spending money lots on these Fireflies and Shermans. And the Firefly's an okay unit really to get. Actually, it's not really a good unit to buy at all for the Poles. But you notice everything went to crap when all the Cromwell Mark 6s died. That's because those are really the like standoff unit versus Luftwaffe. And like
true.
A Firefly is great when you're fighting against Panthers and Tigers, but when the best thing they got is a Stuck 3, it's extremely overkill.
True. Absolutely true. I think I'm really surprised, by the way, to see this Maltias are coming on in with a couple of 88s. They're setting up very, very aggressively.
Yeah.
And he's just trying to bomb everything but Jesus out of this Firefly.
Yep. And that's really the best thing he can do, because he can't really bring any units over the hill to try and kill it. And if he can just stun it, force it to retreat, capture the hill, and then maybe he can actually intercept a Firefly if it's 88 that's moving up. Seems like it's going to reverse off the hill.
Oh, dear Christ. Piot.
Oh, he's going to reverse off that hill, Khan. Is he?
Piot, yeah, but there's a Piot that was just that almost took out that Stu. Oh. And had that happened, honestly, that might have actually broken the German advance.
Oh, yeah.
Black 36 that will engage that Crusader.
Yep.
Oh, my gosh. Pinned down.
And pinned down, and the Firefly is just going to get out. That's a shame, because he could have got the Firefly.
There's a Jaeger right there, though.
Oh.
Okay, never mind. All right. Excited for German reason now. Shockingly, by the way, you said the only way the Germans are going to get back in is with a plus three. Check
and
out the scoreline.
We're at a plus three. I'm shocked, Khan. He actually managed to get a lot of ground really fast.
Indeed. I am stunned, shocked, awed, and amazed at this.
Yeah. Like, this is... I don't know, you could do counterattacks like this.
Not with a Luftwaffe, anyway.
Exactly, and he's pretty much got the poles holed up in the main town in the top left corner, and he's gaining more ground. You know, if he wants to win, he needs a plus four. You know, a draw is already pretty good.
Well, a draw is as good as a win in this case. Yeah. You realize how much he was down. I mean, jeez, the poles had him zero at 70%.
Oh, yeah. And our Firefly's now, like, holed up in that little forest. I don't think it's going to survive as the Jaegers getting closer. And really,
he's gonna stun up one Jaeger.
Yeah, he's gonna stun up run, but when you got three more coming at you, it's not. You know, he's gonna be able to reverse out, which is probably the smart move, I have to say.
Another bomb room run. Yeah. Oh, it doesn't. Okay. Had that stunned him up, that might have been a kill.
Yeah, but this is really what allowed St. Blindfire to get like this much power. It's knocking out the Cromwells. He's got the 88s covering the 88s. And when you have this many 88s, even if the enemy does have artillery, it's too many targets. God, it's too many targets. Those two star 88s can, like, they're pretty decent at dodging artillery fire. I mean, not the best, but it's better than no stars, essentially. Sure. And the air power. The air power has been on point this entire match for St. Blindfire.
Well, except for losing those two, the B1 and the B3. Yep. I will argue that was kind of a silly loss right there.
And what's good, Joe, for Blindfire is that he didn't get the JU run 88, which isn't really a row-for-row unit in 1v1. Mm-hmm. It's too expensive. He's just been sticking with Messerschmitts and Focke-Wulfs. They don't drop massive payloads, of course.
Wait, go to the south. We see a Faustpatron.
Oh.
So close.
The 88's going to get the kill, yo.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
And that's a beautiful explosion.
That was a good boom. That was a solid...
And wait, here comes the plus four.
Oh, No way.
Oh, you're so close.
No
You're so close to a
way.
plus four. Plus four!
No. No way. How the hell?
Oh, and
I
you know what?
mean,
He's even captured Polish supply trucks in the north.
yeah, he definitely is gonna need those supply trucks too. Holy crap.
The
And
Poles have a
just,
handful of units. Oh my God.
I'm shocked. Like, Jesus, Khan, what happened? Like, what happened?
Oh my gosh. Okay, so we talked before about him bringing basically too many Fireflies against a deck that just does not use it.
Yeah.
He's finally bringing in Shermans, but he's got nothing to hold the ground with.
Yeah, and the problem is that regular Shermans can't outrange 88. You need the Cromwells, but the Cromwells are all dead.
Oh, jeez, there's nothing really to be said about this anymore. And
It's
I was a.
really what happens Poe's first Lostroff. You need those Cromwells, or you need Sextons. And he had one Sexton, but he needed to get Sexton earlier, and he needed more of him. He needed more Sextons.
I'm absolutely ridiculous at question. Internal fragments. There's no debuff that happens with that. Is that armor? I try again. Ammo gets taken on out.
I don't
Again,
know,
every
is
now and
that.
again, you see
Yeah,
one
you
of these
see
new
it.
things. This comes on three. Like,
Yeah.
what the deuce is that?
I don't know, maybe it's just like a general debuff that it affects everyone negately. I'm not entirely sure. I'm sure someone in the comments will be able to correct us.
Look at the eastern side of the map. We're gonna see a little bit of an FU airplane flight. Double Sorsch, guys. You saw it here first.
Double,
Double
I mean,
Sorsch.
when you need recon on top of your recon, he needs to double eyes on and everything.
Oh my gosh!
They're gonna
And when
get
the
it
sh
eventually.
when the stew is now going to start throwing out rounds
Yeah.
at the retreating fireflies, you know this game is over,
Yeah,
folks.
that's not good. We've got another firefly. I don't really think you need fireflies at this point, buddy.
Oh
It's
my
just
gosh!
that's I mean, the Germans are now capturing the town up north.
I've actually never seen that happen. Even when I've played this map, I've never seen that happen.
Yeah, and this is it's absolutely nuts. I mean, he loses like an AA unit, but who cares? I mean, he got the 88 on point, and they're just gonna armor penetrated crew hit. They're definitely dead.
You
No
just chop an
no doubt.
artillery down just to explode the last
Yep.
couple of defenses here.
Yep.
Well, we
But
see a plus five.
yeah, that's that might be. Do you just wanna speed this up to times two?
Okay, at 40, go to put times two.
Yep.
Go.
Go. Because
Folks,
I think we know
wow.
who's gonna win at this point, and it's definitely gonna be the guy in red.
Well, you know that, of course. I mean, good guys wear red, right? Plus
Yeah.
five. I've never seen this happen before, folks.
Whoa, plus, I mean, 15% of the map. That's
Your
not
shooter
a good
wounded.
amount.
Give me a Faust Patron.
Yeah, I
Faust
think
Patron
Gondi's
doesn't
just
kill the
give.
Firefly. Ah,
Yeah,
man.
I think Gondi is just giving up at this point.
He's taking the path to nonviolence, like
Yep.
his namesake. That was a political joke out there, folks. I'm not sure if you caught that, but you know what? The fact that Ryan didn't laugh tells me that I need to get to different material. Oh, yeah.
But just these Messerschmitt runs, I mean, people kind of underestimate those Messerschmitts as they only carry like, one bomb, but they can reload pretty far. Same as the Stukas, that's another deck, of course. And just having like smaller, cheaper planes that can drop like a smaller payload and just keep him constantly coming out is much more useful in a run v run than the big epic orchestra of a carpet bomber.
True. True. Now we are going to see one lone Firefly hunkering in the corner, but folks,
There you
that's
go.
going to be it for
That's gonna be
today.
a
Oh
last
my
unit.
gosh. Wherever you are, please give a round of applause over here to Saint Blindfire. First of all, for
Yep.
sticking that out and then for taking it. Oh my God.
Yeah, I was. He's. If I was him, I would have crit by like
Plus
mid B
six.
phase. Like, yeah, like 6, 12 minutes in, I'd have been like, nope, I'm done. As goes my 88, GG. But he managed to bring that round,
Oh my God.
and he was doing terrible
Oh
at the
my God, look at
start.
the KD.
Oh, I mean, a lot of that has to be padded at the end. Like, oh yeah, at the end, it's just blue on the victim side.
Well, from
It's just,
14 minutes until about 20,
yeah.
nothing but poles go down.
I know, it's just,
Oh my God, you're absolutely right. From 25 minutes
it's
on, it
just
is nothing but
blue.
pole.
Damn. Damn, I want to see the kills or losses, really,
Yeah,
because those
exactly. Okay.
Messerschmitts are on, like, even the Flak 88s, they have been, like, damn.
Okay, so we have one ME-109 that takes out two planes.
Yep.
Holy crap.
Has they?
Yeah, Haas over here. One,
He has
two,
the
three,
kills.
four, five. Five legit armored fighting vehicles, a bunch of infantry.
Yep.
Another Flak 36 takes out what? Another four, five?
Yep.
Another four. There's a hurricane that went down because of one. And shockingly, the things that we thought were going to be big killers, the B3 and the B1, barely did anything.
I know, really, he managed to fall back on the Flak 88 spam, which worked out well. And really, all I can say for Gondi is he needed sextons. He needed
He needed sextons
sextons.
earlier.
He needed a sexton A phase. You really could have used it. Because you want to try and negate Luftwaffe from being able to build up, from getting like the free plus onward Flak 88. Because if you negate Luftwaffe from getting Flak 88, they're done. They're buggered. They have no chance.
True,
But damn.
absolutely true.
Damn, that was
But again,
comeback.
guys, wherever you are, put your hands together for that. That
Yep.
was fantastic comeback. I hope you guys enjoyed that as much as we did.
Yep. And yeah, that's pretty much everything I have to say.
That sounds good for me. So congratulations to Saint Blindfire. Gandhi, well fought, but coming up a little bit short here today. Thanks again, folks. Of course, this is Con Ulrich.
I'm Rangru, take it easy.